Hello friends, today in this video we will be analyzing the simulated results of the dielectric resonator antenna, the basic rectangular DRA that we have designed in previous video. The link is given below in the description of this video. So we will analyze the simulated result of that structure. Before that, we can simply hide this outer radiation box to have a better view. So just to summarize the structure, we have used a 50 by 50 mm substrate, FFO substrate of 1.6 mm thickness, and it has a ground plane on the lower side. And we have used a microstrip line to feed the dielectric structure here, which is a rectangular dielectric structure of size 18 by 20 by 15. 15 is the height of the structure. So we have fed this antenna using a microstrip line. And here we will analyze the structure. So in the previous video, we already had set up the analysis setup as well as the frequency sweep which we want to analyze. So now we just have to simulate the antenna, which I have already did because it takes time to simulate sometimes. So I had the simulation completed for this antenna, and now I have simply plot the results, the different plots, to analyze the properties of or the performance of this antenna. So first of all, the foremost important thing is to get the S11 return loss plot. So we'll plot it by clicking right, mouse click right on results, and then going to the first plot. And by default, it's already selected as S11 in dB scale. So we'll create a new report, and we'll see here, we'll observe here that to get the proper bandwidth consideration, if the curve, the resonance curve, return loss curve should be well below minus 10, and the lowest peak is termed as a resonant frequency. So here with this shape, we are getting the resonance around 3 gigahertz, and it is behaving as a wideband antenna because it is showing like starting from, if you put a marker from here, starting from 2.45, the coverage goes well beyond 6 gigahertz, so it is a kind of a wideband antenna showing that kind of a behavior. As we already discussed in the previous video, the authors, the paper that we referred, the authors didn't mention the other properties of the material that they used, the dielectric material they used. They just mentioned the epsilon r to be 30. So we had to like mention the loss tangent and everything in that. So because of that, because of the parameter not matched as what the authors have chosen for their work, the results are quite different as compared to the author's work. So we can simply compare this graph for a basic reference one antenna. We'll go to the paper, and this is the reference one antenna. And here if you see, the resonance is somewhere around 2.5 gigahertz covering this span, it's not a wideband antenna. It's quite a resonant antenna. So it's different in that sense because the properties are not same for the material. So because of the lack of the information, it's not the same as we have in the paper, but of course we can simply take it as a reference dielectric resonator antenna to understand the rectangular DRA working as an antenna. So here it works quite well at 3 gigahertz and a bandwidth of more than 3 gigahertz again. Now the next plot, we can rename it as S11. The next plot can be VSWR, but it's quite the same as of S11. What we need is to see the radiation pattern of the antenna. So for that, we have to insert the far field setup, infinite sphere, where phi can be 0 to 180 with the step size of 0, with the step size of 90, and the theta the step size of 2 or 1. It can be anything. And now we can simply plot the graphs of far field, create far field, radiation spectrum, radiation intensity, total, and dB scale. So we'll create the plot. Here we'll observe it is plotted for all the 3-5 values. What we can do, we can modify the report, and we can simply see it for 0 and 90. And those are mostly referred as the radiation spectrum curves. So here if you can see, we'll find 0 at 6 gigahertz because the solution frequency was 6 gigahertz, so it's like this. And for 90 gigahertz, it's quite omnidirectional. So these are the properties, radiation properties of the designed antenna. Next, what we can see is to have the gain plot, but the gain plot will be again not at resonant frequency, it will be at the solution frequency that we chose because of having the final mesh. So we chose the highest frequency, 60 GHz. So let us see, just to have a look, for 3D polar plot for gain dB, what is the value of gain at 6? So it is in minus, it's like quite low, it's quite low in terms of value of gain. So but what we can do is to have the sweep in the setup. What you can observe, what you can do is in the sweep, you can have the fast sweep, linear count and everything, and save fields that should be selected. And when you simulate it again, what you can have, when we see the report property, we will have a sweep, setup on sweep, not the last adaptive. We will go to the family and you can simply select the other frequency ranges also. So we can go to 3 GHz and let's see if it's negative again there or not. So we'll see at 3.02, we'll see what is the value of the gain. So here it will take the time, yeah. So again it's negative. Now the reason for this negative value, now this negative value is in dB first of all. So here it's not to be considered that the antenna is of no use, it's showing a negative gain, it's of no use. There are many practical antennas, many practical products of many companies who are showing negative gain in dB. So in that sense, for WLAN application, for wireless applications like Wi-Fi at 2.4 as well as 5 GHz, sometimes the antennas doesn't have to be having the positive gain. They can have negative gain and they can work quite fine, because the gain is basically respect to the direction in which they have the maximum lobe, and it is compared to the other direction and respect to the isotropic case. So that's why this can be considered as a acceptable structure as an antenna working at WLAN frequency, but not for other frequencies. For other communication bands like LTE and 3G, it should be having a positive gain. Okay, so this is just about the simulation results of this TRA that we have discussed. We can simply rename these plots for our reference, radiation pattern, S11 gain, and if we want, we can simply look at VSWR, which is the voltage channel ratio. It will be quite similar to what we observed in S11. The results will be quite the same. So here, if we see, the resonance is here, and here we are having the other part of the curve. But if we observe here, in terms of VSWR, this is quite interesting to observe. In terms of VSWR, VSWR critical limit is 3 dB, so it has to be lower than that. But here the 3 dB level is only in this range. So the antenna is showing a good bandwidth in this range only. Other than that, it's not quite good. So this is the difference which we observe in S11 and VSWR. Otherwise, most of the time they are quite the same curves, giving the same kind of information. So here we can see that VSWR shows us the true behavior, where we have a lesser bandwidth in respect to the 3 dB level of VSWR. So that's it in this video. We have analyzed, firstly we designed in another video the DRA structure, now we have analyzed and simulated the design and analyzed the curves results of this antenna. So thank you very much for watching the video. Kindly like, subscribe, comment, share the channel and the videos in it, and also kindly give your feedback. Thank you very much.